day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Good morning, church. Welcome to Stone Chapel United Methodist Church. I'm Yoo Jung Hong, the pastor here. I'm so glad and see all of you today, especially Diane. She's there. Even she's in wheelchair and she joined us this morning for the worship service. I'm so glad. May each one of us to find that God's grace is abundant love in the worship service. Let us prepare our mind and souls for the worship today. abound in our lives, and we lift our voices in gratitude for these loved gifts from you. We also lift our voices as our hearts cry out our concerns for those who are ill, who mourn, who feel lost. We pray for those who have been devastated by recent natural disasters in the world and in the U.S. There are wildfire in West and Hurricane Sally in Southeast. We remember those who have lost their lives so suddenly. We hold in our hearts the families forever changed by grief and loss. Bring them consolation and comfort. We offer you, Lord, both our joys and concerns so often intermingled in our lives. Be with each of us and for those whom we named with our voices in our hearts. Lord, you have heard our cries and our shouts of joy. Make your presence known to us again through the love and forgiveness of others as we have loved and forgiven them. And now, confidence of children of God, let us pray Jesus taught us like this. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Let us pray. Loving God, pour on your Holy Spirit on us gathered at this time. Bless each of us and open our hearts and ears so that we can take your words into our heart. Help us experience anew the surprise and joy that your presence in the world can bring us. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable to you, O Lord, my rock and redeemer. In your holy name I pray. Amen. As you know, that we are walking in the midst of a pandemic, and we didn't expect this pandemic to last this long. Whether we want to or not, we have to deal with this pandemic situation at home, at work, in the community, and in this world. The longer the pandemic lasts, the more anxiety and worries we have, and we wonder how to cope with them. So I have Finding Peace in an Anxious World by Aaron James Brown with Serenity Prayer. Especially, I want to focus on the first sentence of the Serenity Prayer. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. The last week, I talked about serenity, and this week, today, I want to talk about acceptance. What is acceptance? The book talks about acceptance in a way that many people might think that acceptance is passive. But acceptance is more. It can offer us something deeper and more spiritual active. Acceptance allows us to see the world and ourselves and our loved ones as they really are. Instead of jumping to change, acceptance allows us to make space and receive the reality of what is currently before us. Jesus shows us through his life and ministry how acceptance can be a source of spiritual power and how difficult acceptance can be. Jesus prayed to God for acceptance in Gethsemane with sorrow and agony. My Father, if it is possible, may this cup be taken from me, as not as I will, but as you will. He prayed to God that not his will, but God's will would be done, and that he would accept that will, whatever it brought into his life. Jesus knew it was a prayer before his betrayal and the arrest that would lead his crucifixion. In Matthew, Jesus said to his disciples before he to pray, "My soul is overwhelmed with sorrow to the point of death. Stay here and keep watch with me." Jesus was deeply distressed and troubled. He knew what was coming next for him. It was a painful and agonizing moment. It is a distressing moment of Jesus' prayer that showed us the way of truth and the life to acceptance. When we are in the midst of distress, we go to God in prayer for help because we believe that God is powerful and almighty. We turn to God to support us and to help us, to change us or to change the circumstances. But as we pray, we do not often to pray for acceptance. Jesus' prayer shows us what spiritual, brave acceptance might look like. As I mentioned earlier, Jesus prayed, "My Father, if it is possible, may this cup be taken from me, as not as I will, but as you will. Not what I want, but what you want." Jesus' prayer acknowledged that his crucifixion and betrayal were not in any sense acceptable, but as he trusted in God totally, he was able to accept that things might be wrong or unjust, and God could still make something good out of them. God could still be with him in pain and struggle. His prayer was about surrendering God and giving it up to God, and instead of attempting to control a situation. His prayer shows us the faithful path forward can lead us into into the worst fears. In Jesus' case, it was betrayal, trial, and execution. But acceptance means, as Jesus did, we put our trust in God's resurrection power, and we believe that the worst thing is not the end of the story, and God makes something good out of it. Proverbs in chapter 3 and verse 5 through 8 gives us wisdom, and it says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not rely on your own insight. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will make straight your path. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and turn away from evil. I will be a healing for your flesh and a refreshment for your body." Jesus' acceptance prayer is different from the acceptance found in the serenity prayer, accepting the things we cannot change. Jesus' prayer was accept God's task for the sake of the salvation of the whole world. Our acceptance in the serenity prayer is that we need to accept our limitations, as Jesus showed us. Even though God's task seemed unjust and unfair, Jesus put his trust in God's resurrection power, and eventually the people can be saved if they believe in Jesus. In the serenity prayer, accepting the things we cannot change shows us our limitations, so we can more clearly see God's infinite capability. In other words, the more we accept our limitation, the more we trust in God. Accepting does not mean ignoring. Accepting might mean accepting and embracing our grief, rage, sadness, and confusion over the situation as it is. There are things that are beyond our control or ability to change. For example, natural disasters and such as a hurricane, wildfire, tsunami, and earthquake. It means accepting the reality that is before us and laying down the energy we've been using to keep the reality at bay. That leaves room for God to enter in and accompany us on whatever spiritual journey our reality has brought us to, even if it is a painful one. Anxiety, panic, fear, depression, and shame might appear in us where we sit still. It is easier to deny these things than to sit and accept that they are part of us. It is easier to try to fix something outside of us than face the turmoil inside of us. Ironically, we do not welcome anxiety, panic, fear, depression, and shame, but it is in this very tender place of anxiety, panic, fear, depression, and shame that God meets us fully of motherly compassion. This week, as we learned about accepting the things we cannot change, enlightens us to our limitations so we can more clearly see God's infinite capability. In other words, the more we accept our limitation, the more we trust in God. I would like to introduce to you the welcoming prayer. This prayer was first articulated as practiced by Mary Mrozowski in the 1980s, while she was studying with a priest and experienced contemplative outreach. There are three stages of a welcoming prayer. First, focus, feel, sink in. Become aware of whatever is happening in your body and your soul, sinking to truly allow and accept what you are feeling and experiencing without judging or attempting to change it. Be deeply aware of God's presence. And then secondly, welcome and name. Whatever you find, welcome it in words and spoken or unspoken, even if it is something you find challenging. For example, welcome fear, or welcome pain, or welcome confusion, with all the fitting words of welcome. And then thirdly, let go and let God. Once you have felt and welcomed and named the experience you are having, begin to release it in whatever ways possible. Release yourself physically and emotionally by using words. For example, God take my pain, fear, and confusion. Or I let go of desire for affection and control. So this time I would like to practice all together. So first one, please close your eyes. And then listen and then think about, become aware of whatever is happening in your body and your soul, and sinking to truly allow and accept what you're feeling and experiencing without judgment or attempting to change it. Be deeply aware of God's presence. And then this time is welcome and name. So whatever you find, welcome it in words and spoken or unspoken. And this time, let go and let God. Once you have felt, welcomed, and named the experience you are having, begin to release it in whatever ways possible. Now open your eyes. This week, I encourage you to practice this welcoming prayer. So I pray that through the welcoming prayer and accepting the things we cannot change, we may find God's presence and peace in the midst of the pandemic and trust in God in all things in our lives. Amen.
We have
you have loaned to us. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, through the welcoming prayer, accepting the things we cannot change, you may find God's presence and peace in the midst of the pandemic, and trusting God in all things in our lives. With the power of God's love, go in